Hello, this is Randy with Excel for Freelancers, and today we're going to be discussing how to create these amazing checkboxes in your Excel tables. So please join me. Alrighty, let's get started. Okay, so basically the idea is that we're going to put checkboxes in this column. When we select it, we'll check the box on or off. And to get those checkboxes, what we can do is we can go to the Insert, okay, tab of Excel, and then go to Symbol. And once we click Symbol, we'll see a lot of different fonts and a lot of different shapes. We'll use the first two. We'll use the unchecked and the checked. And the check will look like this. So we'll go ahead and insert that. And you see, I've already got it in the blue font here. So basically, it's this B here, but it's a Wingdings font. Okay, so we want to make sure that we want that Wingdings font. And then we'll go ahead and on the upper one, we'll enter the unchecked one, which is this symbol. And then we're going to use the unchecked one. Okay. All right, so we've inserted the two of those. And basically, the idea is we're going to use these shapes for either check or uncheck. And so what we want to do is we want to make sure that all of the cells here are Wingdings font, okay, so that can properly. So we'll just go ahead and highlight those and make sure that we've selected Wingdings and check that, okay? So now that every cell is the correct font in the column that we want to put. Okay, and the idea is when we select this one, we want it to uncheck. When we select this one, we want it to check. So we basically want it in our VBA to change it. Okay, and to do that, we'll go into our VBA. And we can go two ways. Once again, we can do Alt F11. Okay, that'll launch our VBA. Or we can go into the Developers tab here. And if you don't have this Developers tab, simply go into File, Options, okay, Customize Ribbon. You can see the Developers tab right here. Okay, so make sure this is selected. And once we're into the Visual Basic, we want to go into Sheet 1 because this is the sheet that we're going to be working off of, Sheet 1. Okay, so we want to make sure that the work we're doing. And the idea is that when we select a cell here, we want some action. So we're going to be using the selection change. Okay, so in VBA on Sheet 1, you're going to go into the worksheet, click there, and selection change. Now it came up automatically, but you could do it for any other one. Okay, so selection change. All right. And now we're going to say, hey, if we click anywhere in this range here, we want some action to take place. So that range is E7 through E16. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and write some code. If not intersect target range, okay, and that range was E7, correct? E7 through E16, okay, through E16, okay, and parentheses, and then double twice there, and then is nothing, then. And basically what that says is those are like a double negative here, not and nothing. So basically that they'll cancel each other out. And it means if there is some selection in this range, do something. Okay, now what do we want it to do? Well, basically what we want it to do is if this is the target, then we want to change it to selected. If it's selected, we want it checked. If it's checked, we want it unchecked. So basically, let's go ahead and write some code now. Okay, but to do that, we've also got to know what the values are that we need to change, okay, what the actual values are. So we'll go ahead and take a look at this. And if we look here, that checkbox, that value is that B looking thing, okay? So we'll go ahead and copy that, Control C, and then exit out of the cell in order to go back into the VBA. Okay, so basically what we want to say is if the target value is equal print B, okay, close quotation marks, then, okay, we want the target value to change. Target value to change to what? To change to that uncheck marks equals, okay, we're going to go ahead and pause the code just for a second so it doesn't run while we're copying and pasting this. So that is looks like this double mark here. So we'll go ahead and copy and pat, copy that and exit out of the cell. We'll go back in to VBA, and then we'll do a quotation mark, copy, paste that in, and then end the quotation mark. So basically we're saying if target value is B, then change it, okay? But if it's not B, right, if it's not the check mark, then we need to change it to the check mark. So we're gonna write some code there also. Else, meaning if it's not this, then we need to change it to this, okay? So that we only have two options. Else, then all we need to do is copy that, right, and change it to that, okay? So now we have this. And now if we see how that works, now we can reset the code again, okay? Simply by going in here, resetting the code, going out, moving it over, and look. And now when we click here, it's checked. When we unclick there, okay? And now it works. All we need is that one line of code. Now it would also be nice that when we select a specific row, that it would be nice that that row shows up differently than the others, so the selected rows are different. And we can do that through conditional formatting. And to do that, we'll highlight the whole table, but we're gonna get a bug when we do that, and that's okay, we can get around it. So here's the bug, and it's basically saying what happens when we highlight more than one row. And so we can fix that, and simply by writing some code, if the target count is greater than one, then exit sub, okay? And that's all we need to do. And we'll reset that, okay? And then we go back into this, and now when we select highlight all the cells, we don't get any bug, okay? So that's something you'll wanna do on selection change. You'll need that. And so to do that, let's go ahead into our conditional formatting. But before we do that, we wanna copy this particular B, because that's the one we want to use for the conditional formatting. So we'll copy that, exit out of the cell, highlight the entire table, go to conditional formatting, and we're going to create a new rule. And we'll use a formula to determine which cells to format. Okay, and that formula is going to be this. Basically, we click inside here, and then we're going to click on E7, which is the first row. Okay, and then equals, and then quotation marks, paste that B in there, okay? And basically the only important thing is we need to remove this dollar sign from before the 7, because we want this relative to all of the rows in the table. We don't want to write conditional formatting for each row. So once we remove the dollar sign, that can be used for every row. And now we want to format this row differently. So let's go ahead and format that. Then maybe we want to add a fill. And we can add some fill effects. So we can choose a color. Let's say we choose this color. And then maybe something a little bit slightly darker. So we can go back in and then go to more colors. We can choose just a little bit of a darker color. Okay, and we'll select from light to dark. Click OK. Maybe we'll want to bold the font. So we'll go into font, click bold, and click OK. And then we'll click OK. All right, and since we had the entire table highlighted, it knows what range. So when we go back into conditional formatting and manage those rules, okay, you'll see that it's already got the range E17 to L16 already highlighted. So we are good with that. Okay, so now once we select a particular row, automatically it changes. All right, so that looks really nice. Okay, there are other things that we may want to add to this to make our table look great. We may want to add a select all ability. And we can do that with a checkbox on the top, just like have you seen in many applications. So we can do that. We'll type in select all. And I've already formatted it, but you'll want to format it to the right justification here on the alignment so that we have some space for a checkbox. And we'll go ahead and put a checkbox in there, back into the Developers tab, and we're going to click on Insert, and then under Form Controls, we're going to use this checkbox here, okay? So we'll go ahead and insert that checkbox, and we'll just place it up here for the time being, because we want to be able to see it, and we have our own text already, so we don't need the text there. So we'll just remove that, And then we'll go ahead and size the checkbox appropriately, about like that, and we'll place it inside the cell area there. Okay, so now now what we want to do is basically when we select this, we want all of the items in the table to be selected. And when we unselect it, we want none of them to be selected. So to do that, we're just going to write a little bit of code. And the first thing we want to do is get the identity of this checkbox. And so to do that, we'll just control click on it. And we see that it's checkbox 7 here in the upper left. So we're going to copy and paste that name so we don't have to rewrite it. And then we're going to go into our VBA. And from our VBA, what we're going to do is we're going to right click anywhere. And we're going to create a module. Okay, so right click and create a module. And that's going to place a module down here. And now we want to name that module. In this case, we only have one module, but when you do your own projects, you'll be creating many modules and you want to name them. So it's always good practice to give them a name. We can do that by clicking on the properties window here, and that's going to bring up our module. And it may be placed down here for you or on the right. I've placed it on the right, but wherever it's placed, we can just go ahead and rename that. And we will rename that to, we'll call it check all max. Okay, any name is fine as long as you know what it is. And you have to make sure that the name of this macro, the name of the module is not the same as the macro. You want to make sure those are always separate. So we're going to write a macro now, and that is going to be, we'll call it check all and none, because we're going to use it for both checking all and checking none. Okay, so, and basically what we want to do is when we check this, we want to check them all. When we check it again, we want to check none. And we can do that with just a few lines of code. All right, so basically we want to know what is the state of the checkbox, right? What is the state? Meaning, is it checked? Is it unchecked? And to get that state, we can write a little bit of temporary code and just to see what the state is. Message box, okay? And then we're gonna start out with sheet one because we have to designate the sheet because we're inside a module. So Excel won't know what sheet we're on unless we designated it. Sheet one, okay, checkboxes. And then we need to know the name, and remember we copied that so we can paste that checkbox 7. Okay, and we need to know the name of that. So what is the value of that? Okay, so we can click here and then just click the value, and that is going to tell us what the value is when we run that code. So we can run that right now, and it's going to tell us that it's 4146. Okay, that's kind of a weird code, but that's for the unchecked state. Okay, and then what about for the check state? So let's go ahead and check it, right? And let's see what that value is. And that's going to be 1. Okay, when it's checked, it's 1. Okay, and there's actually a third state to check boxes, right? And that is, let's go ahead and look at that format, and we go into format, right click, format control. We'll call it mixed. And so that's often used when, you know, it's some checked, some not checked. So that's an important, so that looks like that. And now what is the number that Excel assigns to that? So we can go ahead and run this code, click in there and click run, and that's going to tell us it's 2. So we have 2 and 1 and minus 4126 or something like that, but we won't need to remember that. Okay, so all we need to do pretty much is change this to if sheet 1 checkbox value equals 1, right? That means if they're all checked, that if the value is 1, we want to check them all. Okay, then what do we want to do? Well, what we want to do is we want to check them all. Okay, we want to check them all, right? And how to do that? Basically, give them all this value here. This is the value we want to give them to. It's that B. So we're going to copy that. Okay, and we have basically E7 through E16. We're going to assign all those the same value. So we go back into our code here, okay, exit out of the cell first, back into the code, and what we want to do is sheet one, we can actually, since we're going to be using sheet one, let's go ahead and refer to it with sheet one, okay, like that, and then we don't need to continue to assign sheets anymore. So we bring this up between the with and then with, and now we can get rid of the sheet one. We don't need that anymore, okay? And then what we want. We want dot range, okay, and there was E7, right, through, right, E16, okay? And we're going to assign those all the same value, so we can simply do that by equals and then put that little B in there, okay? So if it's 1, we're going to put the B, but what if it's not 1? Else, okay, that means if it's not 1, what should it do, right? And basically in that case, if it's not 1, we're going to clear it. And remember, the cleared is this one right here, right? Is this one right here, is this double marks here? So we're going to copy that one, right? Else, okay, all we're going to simply do is dot range, again, E7 through E16, value equals, and then quotation marks, paste, and then quotation marks. So that's it. That is all the code that we need to write for this. So basically what we're doing is if the values, if they're checked, then we want them selected. If it's not, check. Okay, let's go ahead and put that to work. And basically the way we want to do is we want to assign that macro. So let's copy the name of the macro, okay? We're going to go back into Excel, okay? And we're going to take this checkbox, right click it, and we're going to assign a macro to it. Okay, and we only have one macro, but when you have many, many macros, you'll want to. So we're going to select the macro that we created, and that's it. Okay, and now unselect it. Now when we click it once, click it not. Great. So now it works really well. Okay, and we can take this even a step further. What about if it's mixed? Right? In this case, remember we had that third value, that mixed value. It would be nice if when we select something like here, it gives it that mixed value look, which is kind of more accurate, right? So we can do that very easily with some additional code. And we can go back into the developer. And this is the one, basically what we're saying is when we make a selection in this area, we also want to add something in. Okay, so basically what we want to do then is we want to make that checkbox that mixed. And remember that was the value 2. So all we need to do is call that checkbox. So it's checkboxes. And if you remember the name, checkbox 7, I believe, right? Let's check that out, right? And checkbox 7 and the value equals 2, right? And that's what it was, right? And I believe it was checkbox 7. Right, check, well, there's a space between there. I'll put that space in there. Otherwise, we're going to be in trouble. And so now when we click here, it gives it that mixed, you see? Now, when we select all, select none. And that is how you add selecting all checkboxes to a table, and it makes it really easy and really functional. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you do, please like and share as much as you can. It is always greatly appreciated. And I'll be back next week with another video. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and select the Send Me All Notifications options so that you can get our videos to you right away as soon as we create them.